My name is Ria and today I am going to perform an experiment based on the solubility of acid, base and salt. So firstly, let us know what is acid. Acid is a compound when dissolves in water yields hydronium ion, example citric acid or hydrochloric acid. Secondly, what are bases? Bases are the compound which dissolves in hydronium yields to give out salt and water, example C17 H35COONA, that is our daily used hand wash. And at the last, what is salt? Salt is formed by the complete or partial replacement of the replaceable hydrogen. Example, sodium hydroxide, that is our eating salt, or the calcium carbonate. Now, let's begin with the experiment. For checking the solubility of acids, I have a lemon, which is the example which contains citric acid. I'm going to put it in the water. And let's check whether it's soluble or not. So, let's try it now. Sometimes when we see this, we can conclude that acid, which I have used citric acid as lemon, is soluble in water, as you can see here. Therefore, we conclude that acid is soluble in water. Next, let us move on to bases. Moving on to the second one, that is the bases, I have sodium stearate, that is C17H35COONA, that is sodium stearate, the hand wash, and amount of water. I'll pour into it. Sometimes when we see the sodium stearate, the base is getting collected down, so we can say that the base is insoluble, but the bases which are soluble are called alkalis. We have come to the last one, that is the salt. Now I have a sodium hydroxide and calcium carbonate. I will be putting into the water. As we all know, salts are soluble and also insoluble. Let's check which is soluble and which is insoluble. I'll put the sodium hydroxide into the water and the calcium carbonate, that is the powdered chalk, and the sodium hydroxide is the eating salt that we eat usually. Let's check the result after some times. After some times when we see, we can observe that sodium hydroxide, the salt, is totally soluble in water, as you can see, and the calcium carbonate, the powdered chalk which I have used, is insoluble. As you can see, the particles, the calcium carbonate is settled down. Now, I hope you have understood the concept of acid, bases and salt. Now, we have come to the conclusion part. The first thing we used was citric acid. And the acids, they increase the concentration of protons when they are dissolved in water and suppresses the water and hence get dissolved in water. The second was bases. I used sodium stearate. The number of hydrogen in sodium stearate was very less, so it did not get dissolved in water as we saw in the experiment. The third and the last was salt. The salt, I had two types of salt, NaOH, that was sodium hydroxide, and calcium carbonate. Sodium hydroxide is a solid crystal and has good melting point. So when I pour it into the water, it easily got dissolved. And calcium carbonate, not a single part of the calcium carbonate did get dissolved in the water, as it did not contain even a single part of hydrogen. Rather, if we would use the calcium bicarbonate, as it contains hydrogen, it would have been dissolved. But at the last, acids are soluble. In water, bases are not soluble, but which bases are soluble are called alkalines. And at the last, some salts are soluble and some salts are insoluble. Thank you.